So everyone topic my presentation is role of MDCT in evaluation of renal masses. I am Dr. Vivek, PG resident, Department of Diagnosis, Dr. RML Hospital, under the guidance of Dr. Kavita Wani, Associate Professor and Head, Department of Diagnosis of RML Hospital. So kidneys are paired organs, are seen in endoperitoneum, inclusion of renal capsule and renal dynephric tract. Renal masses can range from cystic solid or complex solid cystic lesions with highly vascular and ancient tissues within. Renal cystic masses range from simple cyst to complex cyst with high malignant potentials, and they are evaluated on the basis of Bosnian classification, which counts the presence of septae, wall thickness, enhancement, calcification, enhancing nodule within the mass and within the cyst. Renal malignant solid masses include RCC, which is renal cell carcinoma, urothelial carcinoma, lymphomas, and mets. Spreads the most renal cord benign solid masses include angiomyolipomas, hemocytomas, inflammatory pseudotumors, and pseudo lesions like hyperpigmented polymorph attending. It has been seen that RCC tendency of vascular invasion of patient renal veins under inferior vena cava. So we need to do imaging in order to differentiate between benign and malignant masses, and imaging not only guides the patient making management decisions, but it also helps for proper characterization of solid lesions. Proximal imaging is very, very important for staging patients and for assessment of weaknesses in patients who are already treated, and proactive surveillance of patients who are at high risk of having some disease. So tumors, adrenal renal tumors include the adrenal tumors include papillary adenomas, oncocytomas, renal cell carcinomas, which include clear cell carcinoma, papillary renal cells, chromophore carcinomas, and renal medullary carcinomas. Neuroendocrine tumors include RCC neuroendocrine, small cell neuroendocrine tumors, well-defined neuroendocrine tumors. Mesenchymal tumors seen in adults include angiomyolipoma, leiomyosarcoma, rhabdomyosarcoma, and angiosarcomas. Tumors seen in children include nephrogenic breast, nephroblastoma, pediatric, cystic nephromas. Miscellaneous tumors include metastatic muscle, stem cell tumors, and renal hematopoietic tumors. So on this paper is to identify the renal masses and characterize them based on location, imaging features, and invasion. A study was carried out in Department of Diagnosis of Dr. RML Hospital in total of 40 patients. We started with USG, the first investigation patients with some renal pathology. For them, a CCT test was done, and the CCT was done on a 128-size Siemens smartphone scanner CT machine. The patients who were having clinical suspicion of renal tumors were USG detected. Incident renal masses were included in the study, while those who were severe with allergic contrast in the past or pregnant females were excluded from study. We started in the cases. This is the first case, my 55-year-old female with complex abdominal pain for the last 3 months, and USG showing a suspicious marker of internal hypovolemic area in left kidney. So we see these are non-contrast, these are contrast images. We can see that the axial non-contrast image, there is no evidence of fat attenuation or calcification within the mass. However, the mass is large and trying to be in close proximity with the adjacent organ. This is the contrast image. You can see the mass is peripherally enhancing internal hypovolemic necrotic areas. The mass is very large in size. However, it is also in displacing the great vessels as well as causing spaying of vessels. However, the vessels, there is no interluminal content within the vessels. Ventricular system is normal. So, a mass which is large still confined to the perinephric space and not invading adjacent structures. And this is a case of oncocytoma. This is another case 2, a 72-year-old female with complex neck swelling, abdominal pain, and weight loss for the last 5 months. The USG showed a triage 5 red mass with left renal lower pole mass. So these are the axial image of the neck, CCT image of the neck. We can see that the thyroid flow of the thyroid has large and multiple heterogeneous nodules within the thyroid. We can also see that the left pole of the kidney shows a heterogeneously mass with the internal areas of necrosis and internal areas of enhancing tissues as well. And the lower pole of the kidney is totally disrupted along with multiple and large lymph nodes in the retroperitoneal region. So on the histopathology, this neck mass came out to be medullary carcinoma of thyroid. So this is a case of medullary carcinoma of thyroid with metastasis to kidney. These are case 3. We can see case 3, a 32-year-old male with a complaint of abdominal pain for last 2 months. Yoshi showed suspicious heterogeneously mass and internal hypovolemic area in the retro kidneys. So these are the axial and core images of the CCT abdomen. We can see that the lower pole of kidney, there is a mass rising from the lower pole of kidneys, which shows the internal patrination areas within the mass. However, the mass is very large inside, still it's confined within the perinephric fascia, it's not going beyond it. We can see a similar appearing mass within the other kidney, which is smaller in size. So the mass, which is very large, still confined within the perinephric fascia and having fat retention areas within, however, not being so aggressive and displacing the peripheral colon. So the mass, this characteristic, this is angiomyolipoma. This is case 4, a 23-year-old male with complex abdominal pain, repeated UTI for last 2 months. UTI shows the mass of internal hypovolemic area in left kidney and left palpitation system. So these are the axial cord and sacs, CCT abdominal images. We can see that there is a mass in the region of renal parenchyma which is going into pelvis. The mass is less enhancing than the renal parenchyma. However, still it is enhancing by more than 20 HU. We can see that the mass is not causing, not invading on the adjacent structure, not involved in the pelvic system is opacifying, although it's due to mass, there are some mass effects on the pelvic system, still it's opacifying and ureters can be seen. However, when there is no invasion medicine by ureters or any vascular structures. So this is a case of urothelial carcinoma. This is case type, 26-year-old female with complex neck swelling, abdominal pain, and weight loss for last 1.5 months, which shows a heterogeneous isopic masses in abdomen and the region abdomen, peritoneum, and right kidney. So these are axial core and cells, see CT images. We can see that the homogeneous enhancing mass within the, we can see within the right kidney, and similar pain mass is seen within the peritoneum, retroperitoneal region. The mass is seen casing the IVC, aorta, and can be seen casing the bilateral cavity, common iliacs as well. The mass is seen completely occupying most of the abdomen with the involvement both the peritoneum, retroperitoneum. Multiple heterogeneous enhancing, multiple homogeneous enhancing lymph nodes are also seen within in the vicinity in the peritoneum, retroperitoneum, and the very signal during capsule. Similar deposits are also seen in the pleural kidney. So, a gross enlargement of the all of the lymph nodes, lymphonodal mass in the peritoneum, retroperitoneum, along with deposits of the kidney. So, this is case of lymphoma, which is involving kidney as well as involving both peritoneum, retroperitoneum. And this in these patients, we are seeing that the lymph nodes in the cervical region were also involved. This is case of disseminated lymphoma involving kidney as well. These are case 6 or 60-year-old female with complaints of abdominal pain and weight loss for the last 2 months. USA shows the heterogeneous mass in the left kidney. So we see when there is a large mass rising to lower pole of kidney with complete dissection of architecture of lower pole. We can see some tiny calcific area within the mass. However, no fat density mass or hemorrhage is seen in the mass. And the mass is seen to be involving some part of the cranial pelvis and causing complete dissection of architecture of lower pelvic system. The mass, however, no evidence of renal vein invasion or the IVC invasion was seen. This is a case of renal cell carcinoma. There are 7 cases of 3-year-old boy with complaints of abdominal pain and swelling for the last 6 months, which shows heterogeneous mass in bilateral kidneys. What do we see on the CCT images? We are provided with axial core CCT images. We can see the bilateral open kidneys are replaced by heterogeneous mass, which are heterogeneous solid cystic mass involving bilateral kidneys, measuring around 10 into 8 into 9 centimeters. Approximately both the kidneys. However, the renal veins cannot be seen on the right side, which means that the renal veins are compressed on this side. And we can see multiple enlarged lymph nodes in the retroperitoneum. So, mass which is seen by both the kidneys, with both the kidneys, large and polycystic masses in the 3-year-old boy with retroperitoneal lymph nodes. This is a Wilms tumor. Now, this is a case here, 21-year-old female with complaints of abdominal pain, weight loss, large anemia for the last 6 months. Which shows a heterogeneous mass in left kidney involving most of the abdomen on the left side. So subsequently, CCT abdomen was done. This is non-contrast pain where we see that the calcific foci within the mass is the hypodense areas. This is the contrast lens, post-contrast image. We can see internal hypodense areas along with peripheral enhancement of, in the mass. And the mass is seen to the mass. We can see that the mass is for the right renal veins is invaded. Right renal artery can't be seen. The mass is having loss of peritoneal liver. And there is no distinct planes between the liver and the mass. Diaphragm is also appears to be invaded. The right diaphragm appears to be invaded along with the right psoas muscle. There is involvement of right psoas muscle. We can also see that multiple deposits in the pleura and the mediastinum can be seen, which are enhancing. So a 21-year-old female, young female with internal calcific areas within and having large mass, which is very infiltrating, which is involving in the liver, diaphragm, metastasis, peritoneal deposits, mediastinal deposits, pleural deposits, along with an inversion of the adjacent structures. It's involving bowel, it's involving liver. So in a young age, this kind of mass, possibility of primary neurocranial tumor, PNET is a first differential. However, this also can be a RCC. So we are coming to the results. We see in the 40 patients who underwent the study, 14 were angiomyolipomas, 8 cases were renal cell carcinoma, and 4 cases of metastatic lesion, 4 cases of urothelial carcinoma, 2 cases of lymphoma, 2 cases of oncocytoma, 4 cases of Wilms, and 2 cases of PNETs were seen. We come to the discussion part. We see that the ultrasound is very useful for detection renal masses and characterizing within solid or cystic. The ultrasound has a very important role in dividing masses between solid or cystic masses, since cystic characteristics are very well developed in ultrasound, and it also guides the patients for whom do we need actually the CCT is required. Though coming to the role of MDCT, MDCT is accurate in detection characterization staging renal masses. The examination includes non-lens scans, which detects fats, calcification, hemorrhage, and proximal fluid. We do scans in different phases for initial 25 to 70 seconds we see corticomandibular stage. Then next 80 to 180 seconds we do nephrogram, and then after 100 seconds we start with delayed stages. The corticomandibular phase is nothing very important to differentiate renal pseudotumor with the hypertrophic column burden from a renal neoplasm. It also evaluate depicts the renal vasculature and helps to diagnose the renal tumor extension to renal veins or IVC. The nephrogram phase is very important to differentiate between renal mass and normal renal medulla. Therefore, most valuable for detecting renal masses and recognizing intermediate lesions. Excretory phase is very important for use of evaluating renal masses since it shows the accumulation of the renal pelvis and there is a persecution of renal pelvis as well as ureters. So here we conclude the renal masses. They range from benign to complex masses which can invade the resident structures, and our paper very well demonstrated that MCT is very important, very helpful, and can successfully utilized and the techniques of choice to confirm a diagnosis differentiate between benign versus malignant masses and resist extent and status invasion of the adjacent vasculature and adjacent organs for better pre-op and post-op outcome. Thank you.